Your people are appreciative of suggestions that come from the group. Nobody tries to, you know, put down or have negative remarks on the suggestion. Right, that is an example. Okay, next. Another benefit. You could develop better communication with your team through reflection on their values and identifying things that work. We mentioned that already. So better communication with the team. Why? You like to communicate with people who are positive minded. Even in Bible sharing and even in evaluation, diba? We like people who can help us rather than people upon sitting down saying, tatama na rin ba? Ay, sorry, Ilocano. Ano ba namang mukha yan na naman? Ay, naku, nandito na naman siya. Siguradong marami na namang question ito. If you start like that, there's already a hindrance with regard to some progress in the meeting. Kasi you already started with some kind of negative attitude or negative remark. So when I'm talking here about positive thinking, that includes also positive attitudes. Remember the Beatitudes. The Beatitudes are about attitudes. Attitudes of being. So team meetings can be turned into positive, energized, and future-oriented sessions instead of those that bog in problems and issues of the past. You notice that when you are positive-minded, people easily come to the meeting. Lalo na kung hindi lang pera ang pinag-usapan, no? But when you start with problems, parang nakaka-drain and it is de-energizing. You have to carry your feet to go to that meeting because you know that what we will be talking about again are things that bog down the spirit. Okay, thank you. Next. Identify, so learning outcomes for appreciative inquiry learning modules. Identify when it is appropriate to use appreciative inquiry. I said that appreciative inquiry is a tool. It's a method. It's not the right method to use all the time. It has its limits. But for purposes of moving on with the catechetical ministry or biblical ministry or the youth ministry, the different ministries, 18 ministries in the CBCP, we are reminded to use this once in a while, appreciative inquiry. So ito yung gagamitin natin dito sa catechetical. Know the theory and practice behind appreciative inquiry. We'll learn that later. Develop appreciative inquiry interviewing skills. So, the interviews, because this goes with, kaya ka inquiry, it is goes with asking questions. So, the questions that we ask have something to do with appreciation. So, we ask questions like, when we say, what are the best practices in Kalingapayaw? What are the best practices when it comes to catechesis in Central Luzon? Yeah. You do not say, how much was our deficit from 2002 to 2012? Everybody will become hungry in no time. Ganyan ang pinag-usapan natin. So, the art of questioning is also very important here in appreciative inquiry method. Identify how to apply appreciative inquiry to planning. According to Father Dex, one of our team members, you are going to design your own programs at the end. So we have to have in mind what we want to do, what we want to have, what we want to happen. In May of this year, we're going to have our strategic planning in Iloilo for the Bible Apostolate. Why? Because we are looking forward to 2021. And 2021 is the 500th year of Christianity in the Philippines. So what can the catechetical ministry say is its contribution to Christianity in these 500 years? What can the biblical apostolate say would be its unique contribution to Christianity 500 years in the Philippines? Meron ba? Kaya kailangan natin ng planning. Kailangan natin ng strategic planning. And this is one of the methods used. Have the skills to engage in appreciative inquiry conversation. Kahit sa pag-uusap, kailangan andito sa ating consciousness na ang ating kinagamit ay appreciative inquiry. Understand the benefits of appreciative inquiry in evaluation. Alright. Next. Meron pa ba? Explore how to use appreciative inquiry for community engagement, for the involvement of the community. Have access to bibliography and the resources to undertake assessment if studying towards a master's degree. Ah, ito, hindi natin yan kailangan. Ultimately, the goal is to provide you with the confidence and knowledge to apply appreciative inquiry in your own organization. Ito kasi nasali dito kasi we have undergone appreciative inquiry methodology with the IPD. So, sinama yan kasi may meron kami mga kasama na nagre-research for degrees. Okay. So, may mga processes ito. The first process in appreciative inquiry is to discover. So, apat na B yan. Actually, lima, pero pinagsama itong dalawa. Discover. The identification of organizational processes that work well. That starts with discover. What are the things within the organization that work well? For example, in the biblical apostolate, we have 13 regional centers. So, nandiyan na yung structure. Very easy for Philippine Bible societies to send Bibles because we have 13 regions, regional centers. Under each region, you have we have somebody in charge, which we call a director, biblical director. The biblical director has diocesan directors. Under the diocesan directors, you have the clay coordinators. And then identify kung sino ang ano nasa Northern Luzon, John Paul Bible Pastoral Center. Na-identify kung sino ang mga places under Central Luzon, under Eastern Visayas, Western Visayas, Central Visayas. In Mindanao, even Mindanao, they are clustered. Naditama, Sambasuli. Sambasuli means Sambuanga.
Basilan.
Sulu. And Ipil. Yan. About Naditama? Davao. Digos.
Tagum.
Mati. Alright. How about Kabustan? Kamusta?
Cagayan
de Oro.
Butuan.
Butuan.
Surigao.
Tandag.
Malay-balay.
O, ganun. So, na-identify, meron pa nga silang mga pangalan. So, the existence alone of regional centers in the Philippines is already a good point. So, this to identify ano yung mga magagandang meron. Isa pang magandang meron sa Bible Apostolate. I'm speaking of the Bible Apostolate because I'm the Executive Secretary of ECBA, Episcopal Commission ng Biblical Apostolate. So, I'm very conversant with the structure. Ano pang isang maganda? Ang isang maganda, dalawang beses kami nag-meeting every year. Thank God, nandoon palagi yung mga bishops. And I'm very proud of that because ang aming chairman, si Bishop Ambo. O, pag nagsalita si Bishop Ambo, nandoon yung Bishop Vice Chairman. Si Vico Campo ngayon ang Vice Chairman. Nandun yung mga member bishops. Very encouraging because they are there present. And then the Bible directors, mga pari yan. No? They are there also present. So, for example, for Northern Luzon, we have June Nuesca. And then for Central Luzon, meron si Father Jess, Father Jess Layo. Tapos Central Visayas, nandun si Father Dondon Aquino. Sa Eastern Visayas, ayun ang ginag-attend ng meeting, si Monsignor Rob Redillo. And then Western Visayas, nandun si Father, ito yung mga bata na nag-attend lagi, si Father Elmo Montaño. And Father Elmo takes charge of the formation, the catechetical ministry, the biblical ministry, pero laging present yan. And they spend their own money, the money of the region, but they are there. That is very encouraging for me. So those are the positive points there. And then pag sinabi mong, please submit your Bible collecta. It is there in the, anong tawag ito, yung maliit na booklet, Father? Ordo. It is in the ordo. Please submit your collecta. Ah, pinipirma ko lahat. Pinapadala ko sa mga economists. At sinasabi ko, hindi kayo nagbayad nung 2002 hanggang 2012. Siyempre, nahihiya naman kasi nakikita ng lahat. Binibigay ko sa lahat ng obispo yan. Yan. Ako, taga Bayumbong, pero ang Bayumbong, hindi nagbayad ng 10 taon ng bishop. Paano yan? Yan. Tapos binibigay agad. That is another positive point. They pay attention to their, to their obligation. Very encouraging for me. Very inspirational. So, yan. So, discover and identify what are the good things that you find in your own group. And then dream, the envisioning of processes that would work well in the future. What are other things that can improve if this is what it is now? What are other things that can improve it in the future? Oh, so one thing that we saw would be, would it not be better to divide Mindanao? Kasi isa lang ang kanilang Bible director, ayun, namatay tuloy. Sobra-sobrang kanyang trabaho. Siya ang in-charge sa prison. Si Father Rojo. Oo. Siya ang in-charge sa prison. Siya ang in-charge sa mga schools doon. Siya ang in-charge ng, sabi ko, sige, tanggapin mo lahat. Ayun, namatay tuloy. Kasi malaki ang kanyang responsibilidad doon. At saka maraming bishops ang may sakit ngayon dahil sa stress. So, isingit ko lang ito. There are many things that I read, and one of the things that I read is about health of USBA, because I'm a senior citizen, local citizenship na. And one of the things that I found out, stress is number one cause of death. No? Kaya huwag kayong magpa-stress at ma-distress. If you cannot express, you better express it in some other way. Yan. Saka yung mga stroke. Stroke is with the brain. Heart attack is with the heart, of course. And one of the causes of that is because of four things that my doctor told me. Sabi niya, sleep, ha? You have to have enough sleep. Water. You are not a water person. Sabi sa akin, you have to drink as much as possible. And then exercise. You have to exercise yourself every day. And then food, yung diet. Sabi niya, huwag ka nang kakain ng kanin, ha? Sabi niya sa akin, sabi ko, sige, anong kakainin ko, doktor? Root crops. Go back to the basics. Come on. Anong ginahin ko, mabata ko. Yung gabi, yung kamote, yung kamoteng kahoy, yung mga, yun, yung mga root crops. O, sige po. Kaya, hindi na ako nag-maintain ng medicine kasi yung maintenance na yan, mini-maintain lang ang high blood mo. Mini-maintain lang ang whatever is there, i-maintain. Yeah, that is part of critical thinking. You have to analyze. I got my lesson when I got sick. And I, sabi ko, please bring me to the hospital or Father died. Kasi gusto kong malaman ano ba yung cause na kanya kinamatay. So they brought me there to that hospital in Cebu. Ay, aba, sumakit ang ulo kang, sabi ko, bakit sumakit ang ulo ka? Anong binigay sa akin na medicine? Tinignan ko, tapos, akin na yung computer ko, hinanap ko sa computer, ano ba itong binigay sa akin? 500 milligrams ba naman na para sa, ano ba yung nahihilo? Yung vertigo. Jesus, wala naman akong vertigo, ba't ako binigyan ng ganito? So, tinapon ko lahat yung mga medicine na gumawa na lang, uminom na lang ako ng fruit juice, mga intra, mga ganyan. So, pag dinadala yung medicine ko, sabi ba, sorry, doctor, I will not take that medicine. I had headache. dalawang pasyente ito. Nagpadala pa dito sa hospital, tapos ayaw na ng medicine. Ayaw ko talaga, because if you don't take care of me, I will take care of myself na lang. So don't believe everything that the doctor tells you, because I also have a book which says, doctors kill you, something like that. Because there is business that is going around. I have a book that says there also cancer is not a sickness, it's business. No, so you have to be very careful with the things that you hear and the things that you see, because sometimes the things that we hear, that is only for business. Ako, nag-distribute ako ng intra, but I don't tell everybody to take that, because that depends upon your system. Does it respond? Does your system respond to that or what? Kahit na yung sinasabing ano ba yun, yung turmeric na yan. Hindi naman pala lahat ng turmeric ay responsive to the body. The turmeric that is dried under the sun, wala nang epekto yun. Mahal pa naman. It has to be air dry. And it has to be dry inside the house, not there under the sun. But some of them, para madali lang sa under the sun. Tayo naman, dilib ng dilib. O eto ang kainin mo, dapat ito kasi, organic. O sige, yan ang kainin ko. Kaya binibili kong petsa, yung maraming butas. Kasi yung maraming butas, ibig sabihin, hindi yan na-spray. Maraming uod doon. Pero, kinakain ng uod dahil yun ang nagpapataba sa kanina, di ba? So, let's go back. So, dream. There are many things to dream about. To dream means to look forward and see what is it that makes or that will make this group better or this organization better. And then, of course, we design and then we go to the implementation of what we have designed. So, siguro ang Elder Muna, tignan ko ba, do you want to have a home for 13? Sandali ha, tignan ko muna yung what? Back. Para maniwala sila kasi ito, galing sa Wikipedia yun. Let's go to number 2. Number 2. So we use information. Bakit tayo ito? Napaka-masparin. Appreciate your fingers. Number 2 lang.
I like protect.
Ito yung kay Cooper Ryder. Sila yung authors talaga nito ng appreciative inquiry. So katulad ng sinabi natin kanina, ay hindi pala touchscreen ito. appreciate to value, to recognize the best in people. Naintindihan na? Very good. Okay, pataas ka, Iho?
Pataas ka.
Oo. Ito yung authors, si Cooper Ryder. Gumawa sila ng thesis kasi on this. Thank you. Okay, number 2. To increase in value. The economy has appreciated in value, for example. We'll just deal yung mga kailangan natin. Go up. Thank you. Go up pa. Sige. Number 2. To ask questions. To be open to seeing new potentials and possibilities. Our asking questions is for the purpose of finding out whether there are better options, there are better strategies, there is better content or whatever. Halimbawa, yung ating syllabus in the academe. Do this syllabi really respond to the needs of our students? Who dictates this syllabi? No? So, what are the needs of our students? What are the things that our students appreciate which can be upgraded so that they can better learn and be transformed people? Our purpose for catechesis is to see to it that our people are transformed to the body and blood of Christ. Figurative. Transformed to be other Christ. But do our methodologies respond to that need? Do our content respond to that need? So we have to ask questions to help us look forward to things that can improve what is. Okay, next. Okay, thank you. AI is appreciative inquiry. In a central way, the art and practice of asking questions that strengthens system's capacity to apprehend, anticipate, heighten positive potential. So how many times is the word positive repeated there? It centrally involves the mobilization of inquiry through the crafting of the unconditional positive question, often involving hundreds or sometimes thousands of people involved in the research. So let me see. All right.